as we talked about in the last module, like one part, a really critical part of developing a course is to list out clear learning goals or learning objectives for student learning in your course. But just what is a learning objective? Here are some instructors telling you what they think.
A learning goal is a statement about what students should be able to do as a result of instruction.
So it's the operationalization of what I mean by learning or understanding some topic.
A set of expectations that really guide the design of a curriculum or of a course.
So, for example, I want students to understand Newton's second law, F equals ma. And the learning goal or learning goals would then be my way of knowing that a student understands that. I have no way of knowing that a priori if a student starts talking to me. What does it mean that they understand it? It means that they can find and identify forces. It means that they can set up and solve an equation. It means that they can draw a diagram or a representation. So the learning goals are the explicit statements of the things I want a student to be able to do when they know something.
So a learning objective, by definition, is what a student should be able to do after instruction. And the key thing is it's got to be measurable. You need to be able to assess whether a student actually achieved that goal. And it really reflects what you value in student learning. So when I look at your learning goals, I get a sense of what that course is about. So let me give you some examples. Introductory genetics. I might want students to distinguish between different modes of inheritance, a fundamental concept in genetics. Chemistry, describe what makes chemicals react and why reactions go in a particular direction. Again, really fundamental idea. Here's a more specific one, so quantum physics, qualitatively design a semiconductor diode that will only allow current to flow in one direction. And then lastly, a mathematics one, find patterns in data using basic data visualization tools. So again, a skill that we would want students to come out of that class with. So you get a sense that learning goals are something that really communicate to students what you want them to do as a result of learning in the course. But why do you need goals at all? I mean, isn't the syllabus clear? Isn't the syllabus something that communicates to students what the course is about, and just reading the syllabus is going to let students guess at your goals? Well, I want you to think on your own for a moment before watching the rest of the video. How are learning objectives different from a syllabus? So here's an expert in education to tell us what she thinks.
I'm Kathy Perkins. I'm faculty member in physics, and I've done work around partnering with faculty on learning goals. So a syllabus will often only include a list of topics that are covered in the course, and maybe the order in which those topics are covered. But it won't really provide you any information about what you're going to learn about that topic or what you're going to be able to do as a result of learning that topic.
We sometimes have a tendency to articulate those goals in terms of what the teachers are going to do, so what the lecture will be about. But that's a pitfall because that's not a learning goal. That's a teaching goal, and you're not actually then, if you were to measure that, you could deliver a lecture really well, but it doesn't mean the students learned anything.
So, for example, in physics, you might see the topic circuits listed on the syllabus. But a learning goal associated with that would be much more illuminating. So it would say something like, students will be able to design a flashlight that is optimized for brightness or battery life and explain the reasoning behind their design.